It's Sarah, and I just wanted to take a couple minutes to share some things from my heart. I have been participating in a Bible study, Beth Moore's Chasing Vines, and I am learning so much. God is working in my life in ways that I never could have dreamed of. So the first thing that I wanted to share is so many times I feel like we think that our sins are too big for God. And what's that saying about God? So when I first started this study, I thought I was doing pretty good. And then I realized I still have a lot of growing to do. I have been a Christian for a long time, but I know and understand that I just really need to dig in to what God wants to teach me. And so for a long time, I kept thinking, like, why would God want to spend time with me? Like, who am I, basically? And in her study, Beth Moore, she says, He loves to be in our company. As hard as that is for us to fathom and to be company to us. He didn't need his disciples. He could have done everything he came to earth to do without them. But he wanted community. We need community. I have learned that in these last couple years that we can't do it on our own. And now more than ever, especially in this quarantine when we are supposed to be staying home and isolated, so to speak, we need community. We need friends who are going to fight for us, which goes to my next Bible study. but right now, I still want to stay focused on Beth Moore and Chasing Vines. I've been learning a lot about grapes and how they grow and the vine dresser, my Jesus, and how sometimes he has to cut to help me make growth. And I don't mean physically, of course, I mean spiritually. We have some pruning that we have to do as Christians. But most of all, out of this whole entire study, what has touched me thus far to date is the idea is that we just think that what we have done, that God could never forgive us for it. Now, a lot of you know that my husband and I are the missionaries here at Mount Hope Bible Camp. We're camp directors. And so I spend 8 weeks in the summer in camp. And I serve in various positions. Sometimes I'm in the kitchen. Sometimes I'm just Brett's right-hand woman. Whatever he needs, I am there to do it. Sometimes I'm standing up leading worship. Sometimes I'm teaching. Sometimes I'm just being mom to our children because that's a ministry as well. Sometimes I'm doing a lot of behind the scenes things, like I go buy all the groceries. And so I'm staying pretty busy. But my favorite and I would say maybe most important job is the times I get to spend with some of these girls that are campers here at camp. And I like just pour into them, you know, Jesus made you the way that you are, and with him you are enough. And you know, you don't have to look a certain way, you don't have to be a certain way. Some of these girls, it's a horrible thing that has happened to you, but that doesn't define who you are. And I do that summer after summer after summer. I tell these girls, God loves you. He wants to forgive you of everything wrong that you've done. And I'm doing this study and I'm reading a story out of here that Beth Moore shares. And I think, wow. I, summer after summer, pour into these girls and tell them how awesome they are. And I can't believe it for myself. She talks about how at one of her events, she talks about in this story, that she says, I recall praying with a woman who approached me at an event. She was just distraught. She said, I haven't showered in weeks. She says, I don't know what's wrong with me. She choked out the words, blotting eyes that were flowing like brooks. And Beth says, my heart bled with compassion as it became clear that she was so convinced of her own filth that she wouldn't let herself bathe. God only knows how many times she's confessed her sins, but she couldn't accept his forgiveness. I knew the feeling. I knew what it's like to think that God's grace is poured out in endless waves, drenching everyone else but me. And that hit me like a ton of bricks, because let me tell you, I have preached to these girls that God loves you and all you have to do is ask and he will forgive you. And time after time after time, I have failed. And I have thought, well, God's not going to forgive me of that. And it's scripture. She says, self-loathing is such a convincing deception. It has an uncanny knack for persuading us to identify ourselves as an exception to every grace. But words from the inspired pen of a beloved disciple beg to differ, because in 1 John 1:9, it says, if we confess our sins, he is faithful and just to forgive us our sins and to cleanse us from all unrighteousness. All unrighteousness. Cleansed, purified, made clean. And I have been deep in this Bible study, and I have been thinking and praying, and I have just thought, God, I am so sorry for everything that I have done, the many times I have failed him, the many people I have failed, because I'm human. And how God just, when we ask him, if we confess our sins, he is faithful. He is faithful and just to forgive us. He forgives us. He forgives our sins and he cleanses us from all unrighteousness. That has just spoken to me, and I've heard that verse. I've memorized that verse for leadership training. I have known that verse probably more years than not of being alive. And it took this study to really pour out to me to think, while I'm teaching those girls, I have to accept for myself. And so I want to challenge you that it doesn't matter what you have done on this earth. All you have to do is ask, and Jesus will forgive you from all unrighteousness. Now, I'm a song girl, and it just so happens that one of my most favorite songs talks about being clean. And so I want to share that with you today. And so I pray as I sing this song that maybe if you're struggling with something, maybe if you're struggling with the acknowledgement that, hey, yeah, what God's doing for everybody else, he can do for me too. He can change my life. And I can follow him and I can abide in him and just, wow, love him and serve him and love on others. Maybe that's what you need as I sing this song. I just want to challenge you just to pray and just to accept God's forgiveness that he has for you. Get my song up here. There's nothing too dirty. that you can make worthy. You wash me in mercy. I am clean. Washed in the blood of your sacrifice, your blood flowed red. That they realize that through you and with you, they can be washed clean, without spot, without blemish, and that they have an opportunity to abide and to live